Hello everyone, welcome to Global Online University. In today's lecture, I have shared most important MCQ of Logical Reasoning Unit. This video will help you to clear your doubt about the Logical Reasoning Unit and will also help you to score more marks in the upcoming exam. One more important thing I want to tell you that every day at 6 p.m. I'm uploading my video on the Global Online University channel. So do visit our channel every day at 6 and do watch my video to clear your exam. Before going ahead, I want to tell you one important thing which is really important for the one who is preparing for the upcoming NET exam 2021. Global Online University is providing you free video lecture as well as a free mock test. Now the question might came in your mind, how you can get this test? So here is the answer on your screen. To get this opportunity, just download our app Global Online University on your mobile. The second step is go inside and select UGC NET Paper 1 October. Then there you will find two free mock tests, two video lecture free and two notes PDF. Join our course. The fee of our course is $9.99, in which you will get full syllabus video lecture, 60 full syllabus tests, full syllabus notes and previous year paper 2011 to 2020. Students, Global Online University is providing course for the paper 1 in which you will get 60 mock tests with the detailed solution, previous year question paper with the detailed explanation from year 2011 to 2020, full syllabus notes. You can complete these notes within the 1 or 2 days and then you can attempt the test. Plus we are providing you video lecture. For the more detail you can contact on given number. Students, there is very less time and this is the best opportunity for you to crack your exam. So join our course just for ₹9.99 and achieve your dream. Now let's begin with the today's lecture. Which of the following pramana is used by classical Indian school of logic to prove existence of God? In a given question, they ask you, given which of the pramana is used by classical Indian school of logic to prove existence of God? And the options are Arthapati. Arthapati ye Indian philosophy mein fifth a pramana hai by which one can obtain the accurate knowledge of the world. Arthapati is a knowledge arrived at through the postulation. Then is Upamana. Upamana, Indian philosophy mein fourth pramana hai by which one can have a valid cognition of the world. Then is Pratyaksha. Pratyaksha is a one of a three principal means of a knowledge. It means that which present before the eyes clear, distinct and evident. And the last one is Anumana. Anumana, second pramana hai, or the five means of a knowledge, inference occupy a central place in the Hindu school of logic. For this question, the correct answer is option number C. Pratyaksha pramana is used by classical Indian school of logic to prove existence of God. Which of the following school accept only perception as a pramana? In a given question, they ask you, given which of the following school accept only perception as a pramana? And the options given are Nayaya school, new school of Nayaya, Navya Nayaya or a new Nayaya, across in a Bengal, the best known philosopher of Nayaya and the founder of modern school of Indian logic was Gangesha in 13th century. Then is Jainism school. Jainism is an Indian religion which is traditionally believed to be propagated by 24 spiritual teachers known as the Tirthakara. Then is a Buddhist school. Buddhist school or a mainstream sect refer to the sect into which the Indian Buddhist monastic sangha split. And the last option is Charvaka school. Knowledge of reality or valid cognition is called Prama and a source of such a knowledge is called Pramana. Charvaka school claim that perception is the only Pramana or a dependable source of knowledge. So for this question, the correct answer will be option number A. Please don't ignore the explanation of any option because you may receive any question on any option. So please study each and every option carefully. Which of the following concept of Indian logic system denote circumstantial implication? And the options given are Anumana, Arthapaddi, Anuupalabdhi and Pratyaksha. For this question, the correct answer is option number B. Arthapaddi, concept of Indian logic system denote circumstantial implication. Which of the following statements are true in a context of Arthapaddi? In a given question, they ask you, given which of the statements are true in a context of the Arthapaddi? And the statement given are, it is an independent source of knowledge. The second statement is, it is admitted as a distinct pramana which cannot be brought under the anumana or a shabda. Third option is both A and B, and the last option is neither A nor B. Arthapaddi, Indian philosophy may fifth of five means of knowledge, that is a pramana, by which one obtain the acquired knowledge of the world. Arthapaddi is a knowledge arrived through the postulation. For this question, the correct answer is option number C. Both the statement, that is, it is an independent source of knowledge and it is admitted as a distinct pramana which cannot be brought under anumana or shabda, these both statements are correct. Here the next question is, the reason appears to be real or appropriate but in fact is not. With which of the following term the falsi is known as hetva bhasha? And the options given are minor term, middle term, major term and all of the term. Hetva bhasha ye Sanskrit word hai which means falsi in English language. In other word, in Indian logic the falsi is called hetva bhasha. A falsi occur when the middle term appear to be the reason, but it is not a valid reason. So here the most appropriate answer for this question will be option number B, middle term. The inference, a mouse is animal, therefore large mouse is large animal, commit which of the following fallacies? And the options given are Streumann, ye form hai argument ka. And the informal fallacy of having impression of refuting an argument. Then is slippery slope. Slippery slope argument in a logic, the fallacy of arguing that a certain course of action is undesirable or that of a certain proportion is impossible. Then is equivocation. Equivocation is an informal fallacy resulting from the use of particular word or expression in a multiple sense within the argument. And the last option is fallacy of composition. Fallacy of composition, ye informal fallacy hai that arises when a one inference that something is a true of the whole of the fact, that is a true of some part of the whole. Here the most appropriate answer for this question is option number C. Equivocation. Which of the following is considered to be most sophisticated natural theologies? And the options given are Nyaya. Nyaya is the one of the six systems of Indian philosophy, important for its analysis of logic and epistemology. Then is Buddhism. The word Buddha means enlightenment. The path of enlightenment is attained by utilizing morality, meditation and wisdom. Then is Jainism. Jainism is an ancient religion from India that teach that a way of liberation and bliss is to live life of harmlessness and renunciation. Here the answer for this question is option number A. Nyaya is considered to be most sophisticated natural theologies. In inductive reasoning, the conclusion is, in a given question they ask you, inductive reasoning may conclusion, and the options given are probable, certain, definite and predictable. In a inductive reasoning is a method of reasoning in which premises are a view as a supplying some evidence but not fully assured. for the truth of conclusion. So the correct answer for this question will be option number A. In inductive reasoning, the conclusion is probable. Interference is considered to be a mere leap into a dark. Which of the following school consider the above statement? In a given question, they given you one statement, that is, interference is considered to be a mere leap into a dark. This statement is considered by which school? And the options given are Nyaya School. Nyaya School, the best known philosopher of Navya or Nyaya, the founder of modern school of Indian logic, was Gangesha in 13th century. Then is Mimamsa School. Mimamsa School is one of the six orthodox school of philosophy that focus on the art of reasoning, interpretation and application of texts of Samhita and the Brahmana portion of Veda. The third option is Charvaka School. The knowledge of reality and a valid cognition is called a Prama, and the source of such a knowledge is called a Pramana. Charvaka School claim that perception is the only Pramana or a dependable source of knowledge. And the last option is none of the above. Here the correct answer for this question is option number C. Interference is considered to be a mere leap into a dark. This statement is considered by a Charvaka school. Okay, here is the question which I asked you in yesterday class. The question was, in the age of four Veda, the students were admitted to the Vedic school after the performance of which of the following ceremony? And the options given were Upanayana ceremony, Utsarjana ceremony, Shatpata Brahmana ceremony and the Dhanurveda ceremony. Dhanurveda ceremony or Acharya in the time past was an important hunting and military skill before the advent of gunpowder as a friendly combined recreational activity. It is a high action pure sport that requires the precision, patience and skill. Shatpata Brahmana ceremony. Shatpata Brahmana ceremony is a commentary on the Shukla Yajurveda. Then is a Utsarjana ceremony. This ceremony is also called a dispersal ceremony. This was a performed at the end of the academic session in the full moon day of the month of Pausa, that is from January and February. And the last option is Upanayana ceremony. Upanayana, Hindu ritual of invitation, restricted to the three upper varnas or social classes that make a male child enter upon a life of a student and his acceptance as a full member of his religious community. So the answer for this question will be option number A. In the age of four Veda, the students were admitted to the Vedic school after the performance of Upanayana ceremony. This is the last question of today's lecture and you have to answer this question. The question is, of the following statement, there are two statements, both of which cannot be true, but both can be false. Which are these two statements? And the statements given are, all machines make noise, some machines are noisy, no machine make noise, and some machines are not noisy. And the options given are 1 and 2, option B is 3 and 4, option C is 1 and 3, and last option is 2 and 4. Please answer the question. I'm waiting for your answer. I will tell you the answer in my next class. Before winding up for the lecture, I want to tell you one more important thing. Students, Global Online University is offering course for the NetSite exams. Iske detail aapke saamne hi hai. We are providing these courses only for ₹999. To join, please contact on given number or you can also download our app where you will find the free trials. Students, we are providing key for your success. So do join and achieve your target.